Good morning, children. Welcome to our English class. Okay, so today we are going to continue with punctuations. Okay, so what do you mean by punctuation? So last class I told, isn't it? Do you remember? So punctuation is the use of different marks like full stop, comma, question mark, etc. to make the meaning of a sentence clear. Okay, punctuation is the use of different marks like full stop, question mark, comma, etc. to make the meaning of a sentence clear. Okay, and we have learned a sentence begins with the capital letter. Next one, name begins with the capital letter, and full stop is used to end a sentence, and question mark is used to end a question sentence in the previous class, isn't it? We have learned these things in the previous class, and we have done some activities, isn't it? So we have rewrite the sentences, isn't it? So first letter, capital letter, and if the sentence ends, then we have return full stop, isn't it? So all these things we have learnt in the previous class. So today we are going to learn a new punctuation, comma. Okay, new punctuation, comma. See, read the following sentences. Raj, Ram, Rahim and Ali went to the garden. So they have circled something, isn't it? So this mark is called comma. Okay, so if many things many things comes in one sentence, then we have to separate all these things by comma. Okay, the next sentence, my mother bought vegetables, chocolates, milk and honey. So they have separated these things by comma. Okay, that is called a pass, short pass. Okay, you can find a mark that is a pass like comma. So this is known as comma. Okay, this symbol is known as comma. Okay, a comma is a short pass used to separate a series of words. So if many things come in one sentence, then we can separate all these things by putting this comma. Okay, children, like names. Okay, so in the first sentence there are four names came, isn't it? So they have separated the names by comma. And in the next sentence, many things have come, isn't it? Vegetables, chocolates, milk. So they have separated these things by putting comma. Okay, comma is a short pass. Comma is a short pass used to separate a series of words. Okay, children, comma is a short pass used to separate a series of words. So we shall do some activity, okay? Then you will be clear. So insert commas wherever necessary and rewrite the sentences. So we are going to insert commas wherever necessary. Okay, so see the first sentence. One day Rosie, Peter and I went to a garden. So wherever we find a short pass, then we have to put comma. One day, so that is a short pass, isn't it? So we have to put one comma there. One day, comma. So there are two names, isn't it? So we have to separate these names. So Rosie, comma, Peter, and I went to a garden. Okay, so shall we write? So one day, comma, Rosie, comma, Peter, and I went to a garden. Went to a garden. Okay. So wherever we find a short pass when while we reading, then we have to put one comma. Okay. One day, comma, Rosie, Peter, and I went to a garden. Is it clear, children? See, they have written the first letter in capital letter and they have written the full stop there, isn't it? So all these are punctuations. Okay, so shall we move on to the next one? The garden was full of flowers, fruits, and butterflies. The garden was full of flowers, fruits, and butterflies. So, can you identify where we have to write the comma? Can you find out? Yes, there are two things. Two more things came in one sentence, isn't it? Flowers, fruits. So there are two things have to be separated, isn't it? So flowers, comma, fruits. Okay, shall we write? The garden was full of flowers, comma, fruits. So shall we write it neatly? The garden was full of flowers, comma, fruits, and butterflies. Butterflies. So the garden was full of, so this is you. The garden was full of flowers, comma, fruits, and butterflies. So we have separated these two things, isn't it? Flowers and fruits. So flowers, comma, fruits, and butterflies. Okay. So the next one. Yes, I like your doll. Yes, I like your doll. So where we have to write comma? Yes. Yes, comma, I like your doll. Okay. So yes, comma, I like your doll. yes, comma, I like your doll. So you can copy down in your grammar printout. Okay, children? Yes, comma, I like your doll. Have you all understood? Yes. So next one. We ate chips, sandwiches, and chocolates. So in this sentence, two things have to be separated, isn't it? What are they? Chips, sandwiches, isn't it? So we ate chips, comma, sandwiches, and chocolates. Okay, so shall we write? We ate chips, comma, sandwiches, and chocolates. We ate chips, comma, sandwiches, and chocolates. Okay, so in this sentence, these two words have to be separated. So we have put comma. Have you all understood, children? Yes, so write it neatly. Okay, so the next one, fifth one. Rajni, Ma, and Rita are good friends. Rajni, Seema, and Rita are good friends. So where we have to put comma? Yes, Rajni, comma, Seema, and Rita are good friends. So Rajni, comma, Seema, and Rita are good friends. Okay, so Rajni, comma, Seema, and Rita are good friends. Okay, see, all these names begin with capital letter, isn't it? So in a sentence, wherever a name appears, then you have to write the name begin with capital letter. Okay, so have you all noticed Rajni? So the name begins with R. Seema. So Seema also begins with capital letter S. And Rita begins with capital letter R, isn't it? So name begins with capital letter. Okay, children? So have you all understood where we have to write comma? Yes. So wherever you see a short pause while reading a sentence, then you have to put comma. Okay, and the things have to be separated, so there also we have to write comma. Okay, the next one, rearrange the jumbled words to make meaningful sentences. Use capital letters, full stops, commas, and question marks. So they have given the jumbled words. So we have to rearrange the jumbled words to make meaningful sentences. And we have to use capital all the punctuations, like capital letters, full stops, question marks, and commas. Okay, wherever necessary, we have to put all these punctuations. Okay, are you all ready? Yes. So the first one, Dawn pretty has Lata. Doll pretty has Lata. So how to write the sentence? So first you tell the sentence. Yes, Lata has a pretty doll. Lata has a pretty doll. So name should begin with the capital letter, isn't it? So the sentence also should begin with capital letter, isn't it? So what is the sentence? Lata has a pretty doll. Okay, Lata has a pretty doll. So shall we write? Lata has a pretty doll. Full stop. So you have to put full stop at the end of the sentence. Okay, Lata. So sentence and name begins with capital letter. Okay, so Lata has a pretty doll. Full stop. Okay, children. Have you all copied? Yes. So shall we move on to the next one? Yes. So the next one. Second one. Is India a big country? Is India a big country? So what is the sentence? India is a big country. Shall we write like that? India is a big country. Full stop. And the sentence should begin with the capital letter, isn't it? So India, capital I. India is a big country. Full stop. Okay, India is a big country. Full stop. So I is a capital letter and write full stop at the end of the sentence. Okay, shall we move on to the next one? Yes, third one. Chick the grains eating is. Chick the grains eating is. So what is the sentence? Chick is eating the grains. Chick is eating the grains. So sentence should start with the capital letter, isn't it? So chick, C capital letter, C. Chick is chick is eating. Chick is eating the grains. Full stop. Okay, chick is eating the grains. Full stop. C capital letter. Okay, and write full stop at the end of the sentence. Okay, chick is eating the grains. So the next one, fourth one, the last one. Tea or coffee have you will. Tea or coffee have you will. So what is that? Question sentence, isn't it? So will you have tea or coffee? Will you have tea or coffee? Question mark. Okay, and sentence should start with capital letter, isn't it? So W is a capital letter. Will you have tea or coffee? Question mark. Will you have tea or coffee? Question mark. Because it's a question sentence, isn't it? So we have to write question mark at the end of the question sentence. Okay. So will you have tea or coffee? Question mark. Okay, children, have you all understood? Yes. So with that, we have finished this punctuations. Okay, so copy down in your printouts. Okay, study well. Thank you.